Noel Gallagher famously said, if there was no Slade, there would be no Oasis. And Ozzy Osbourne says that lead singer Noddy Holder has one of the best voices in rock ever. And it was Noddy's powerful and instantly recognisable vocals that turned songs like Come On, Feel the Noize and Mama, We're All Crazy Now into huge hits. Well, Slade is about to release a best of album, and I'll speak with Noddy in a moment, but let's turn back the dial to the glam 70s. Noddy joins us now. It is so great to talk to you. How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm awesome. All the better for speaking to you. Now, that hat you're wearing in that last clip, it became famous, and I heard a whisper that you bought it from Freddie Mercury. Is that true, and do you still have it?
I didn't actually buy it from Freddie. I bought it... Freddie used to have a stall in Kensington Market in Kensington in London, and he used to sell shirts and bits of paraphernalia before he was famous. Him and Roger from Queen had this store, and I used to go in there and buy clothes off him, and he used to say, oh, Noddy darling, I'm going to be famous like you one day. And I said, oh, get away, Freddie, you're not going to be famous. And he ended up as Freddie Mercury, of course. But I bought that top hat without the mirrors. I bought the top hat from the stall next to his, and then I put the mirrors on myself. But I didn't actually buy it from Freddie, but it was from the same market.
Yeah, Freddie did go on to do okay, I think, in the famous...
He did
steps.
Okay, yes, yeah. He did. Everything he did, he learned from me, though.
Ah, very good, I love it. I reckon the hat was as famous as your sideburns. When did you finally shave them off?
Oh, I haven't had the sideburns. I had them right up until probably the late 80s they went, they disappeared.
Well, they were very individual and truly massive, as was Slade.
Well, people in the 70s and 80s here in England, people used to sell Noddy Holder sideburns for, so they could stick on. And apparently now I'm the biggest selling fancy dress outfit in the country, and people get the top hat with mirrors, and you get the stuck-on sideburns stuck to the top hat with mirrors these days.
I love it. That's Halloween sorted right now. Now, the band was so massive in the 70s. The Slade Alive album was in the charts for 58 weeks. How crazy were those days?
I know. Well, when we first came to Australia in early 73... We arrived there and we didn't realise how well the album had done. And we came to do a tour to Australia. We did all the race courses around Australia. And when we arrived, Slade Alive had been number one for like months. And our next album, which was Slayhead, had knocked that off the number one spot. And so Slade Alive was number two in the charts. And our next album, Slayhead, was number one in the charts. And we had three singles in the charts all at the same time when we landed in Australia. And we got off the plane and all the press and everything were there to greet us. And then they wanted us to... We'd have this, I think it was a 28-hour flight from Britain in those days. And they wanted us to start drinking this huge barrel load of lager. But we'd already had a skinful on the plane, so it was a bit of a riotous landing.
That's the Australian welcome for you. Sadly, I reckon it might
have been... Absolutely.
It might have been Foster's.
We loved it.
Might have been Foster's
yeah, it was
at the
Foster's,
time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry about that. You hung out with some amazing people, of course, the likes of Bowie, Mark Boland from T-Rex, and of course Ozzy Osbourne. Ozzy's the only one still with us. Have you kept in contact with him?
Oh yes, yes. We're looked after by the same office still. We're still. In fact, for a university over here that Paul McCartney finances. He has guest lecturers there, and I do some guest lecturing. It's in Liverpool. And we had Ozzy and Sharon over to, and I interviewed them in front of the students there. It was a bit of a riotous afternoon because I was telling stories to the students and through the interviews with Ozzy and Sharon that shouldn't really be for young ears.
What are you lecturing
student,
in?
I'm the guessing. Students loved it. The students absolutely loved it.
What are you lecturing in? I'm guessing it's not physics.
No, it's not physics. It's I don't do it all the time. I just guest lecture there. They have guest lectures in. But I lecture on music and the music business, the sort of things that can happen to you, that you have to have a good lawyer, a good manager. Before you have anything else, and a good accountant, of course. Otherwise, you don't see anything at the end of the day unless a good team behind you. So I sort of explained to the students how to manoeuvre the record and the show business.
That is great. That is great advice. I love that because that's what young musos need to hear going into the business.
But
one thing you couldn't be prepared for is I heard a story that you actually saved the lives of two fans after a fire broke out in a club. Is that true?
I did. That
Tell
was
me
in
more.
Canada. Oh, that was way back in the 70s, maybe early 80s, and I was playing pool in a back room in this club with a couple of my road crew, and we were playing pool, and then suddenly smoke started to filter into the pool room, and we opened the door, and there was the club was all ablaze. There was all these flames and everything, and we were racing to try and get out of the club. Obviously, it's pandemonium, and I could hear these screams coming from the ladies' toilets, so I went into the toilets, and I dragged these two girls out and saved their lives.
Wow.
They were very grateful.
I'll bet they were. It's not every day you get your life saved by a massive rock star, so I'm sure they were, but good on you.
My hair and sideburns were a bit singed, I have to say.
Oh, lucky they...
I had to regrow the sideburns.
You had to regrow the sideburns. Oh, tragedy averted twice right there.
Absolutely.
I love it when singers become fans. So we know Ozzy Osbourne's a fan. We know Noel Gallagher. Alice Cooper loves you. And I read that John Lennon said you had a damn fine voice. You've influenced artists like Nirvana. Does it feel pretty nice to hear that kind of praise?
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm 74 years old now, and we formed the band back in 1966. I mean, I left the band in 91, so I've been out of the band longer than I was in the band. But it's great to have the back catalogue still alive and kicking and people still appreciating it, and it's great to have those sort of names still, you know, blagging us up, actually. It's fantastic to have that history and career in the music biz.
Now, one thing I do have to take you up on, Noddy, we look at the titles of so many of your hits. Was spelling a particular strength of yours at school? Because Slade has a special way of spelling things, don't they?
Well, we did have a special way, yeah. It started off with the first really big hit single, which was 'Cause I Love You. We didn't like it on the record label when we saw it saying, because I love you. So we took what was our dialect in the Midlands, in the middle of England, the Black Country it was called, and it was a very industrial area, and our accent and our dialect, it's how people used to write on the toilet walls. And I'd got the lyrics written out in the studio in the dialect, and our producer and manager, Chas Chandler, saw it, because we'd been complaining that it looked a little bit soft, because I love you. And he says, well, don't you write it like the dialect? I've got the lyrics written out. And so that's how it started. And then everybody was up in arms about it and thought it was a great idea. And we did it for loads of records after that.
I love it. What a great explanation. Why didn't I think of that? Off the toilet walls, of course. Now
it was. It was. That's exactly where it came from.
I love it. Let's talk about Merry Christmas, everybody. It is a massive hit, an English Christmas tradition. Did writing that song mean you really never have to work again?
Well, it's a nice pension plan. When it's 47 years old this year, so it's been going a long time, that record, and it's took on a life of its own. When we wrote and recorded it back in 73, we thought we'd got a big hit on our hands because it was getting a lot of radio play. It went to number one in UK the very first day it was released, and it went on to sell a million records just in Britain in 2 weeks. So it was phenomenally successful for us in Europe right away it took off everywhere. But we no way did we ever think it would still be going strong 47 years on. So it is a nice pension plan. We have earned a lot of money from it. And there's been a lot of cover versions as well, so that's a good thing for us, because myself and the bass player in Slade, we wrote it, and so we get royalties from the cover versions also. So that's very nice. Bank manager, he gives me a glass of whiskey every time I go and see him.
I think you and Mariah Carey have Christmas covered with the two songs there for all time.
Oh, absolutely. Me and Mariah, yeah.
Like that. Now, I love that this new release is also coming out in vinyl. That just seems totally appropriate.
It is.
And I love my vinyl. What can fans expect?
Well, it's a cross-section from all the singles we've released from the very late 60s right through to 1991. And it's a cross-section of all the product that we bought out in that time. The record label have chosen what they think was the ones that would all fit together. Obviously, all the big hits are there, but it's pretty much all the singles that we put out in that period of time. So it's over 20 years worth of hit singles, which is great because it's the first comprehensive hit selection that we've had out. We haven't really had a hits collection out for, I don't think, probably maybe over 15 years, but this is a real comprehensive set.
Well, it's a
and
must.
It's a mixture. It's not only the rockers that people know us for, the big, shouty, loudy rock and rollers, but there's a lot of the ballads in there that we had as hit records also.
Fantastic. Something for everyone. Do yourself a favour and grab it. Noddy, it has been such a delight to catch up with you. Thank you so much.
I've enjoyed it. Thank you. Keep on rocking!
just a crazy guy. What a delight. Just one other little quick anecdote about it. That was so huge. And at that time, of course, everyone's wrecking hotel rooms, chucking TV sets out of hotel room windows, riding motorcycles. Noddy used to turn up with a tool belt and actually fix little things that were wrong with the hotel rooms when they went in.
That is
instead
awesome.
Of destroying them. So, yeah.
That is great.
He's one of the wiser heads of rock
Isn't
and
that
rock.
Great? So, what, he'd get the television back out of the pool.
Fish it out of the pool.
Carry it back up through the window.
And give it a pat down with a towel down, and put it back on the cabinet. Yeah.
So cool.
So, come on, Feel the Hits is out now.